Oakland Raiders, Oakland's first round selection, running back Marcus Allen of USC.
I like it.
Imagine this. The Raiders were moving down to Los Angeles. I didn't have to go anywhere.
Good answer the phone.
I mean, how lucky can a guy get?
Hello. Yes. Thank you. It's great to be a Raider. It's great to be a Raider.
I mean, it was perfect.
You know, for a Raider.
Who walks into the locker room and you have Art Shell, Gene Upshaw, Cliff Branch, Jim Plunkett, Ted Hendricks. I didn't say one word going into camp. And I was smart enough to know you already got a target on your back because you're the Heisman Trophy winner. You're the number one draft pick. Don't open your mouth. Just go in there and work your tail off. And that way you can get the players to accept you.
Marcus Allen's first game as a pro in San Francisco against Ronnie Lott and the defending Super Bowl champion 49ers.
I'm going to compete against my brother. And like all of us know, if it's your brother, you want to kill him. And there's one moment in the game where he's running a sweep, and I'm coming 100 miles an hour, and I know he doesn't see me. And I'm getting ready to knock the crap out of him on the sideline. He does a 360, and I missed him. After the game, I said, man, how did you know? He goes, man, I was watching you the whole time.
The Raider veterans were watching Marcus, and they had seen enough.
Ted Hendricks was standing on the sideline, and I remember Ted just saying, just get a ball to Marcus. That gave me so much confidence that he had confidence in me.
Two things that come to mind when I think of Marcus. One, incredibly versatile. There wasn't one aspect of playing the position that Marcus didn't excel at. You could name 20 running backs who were bigger, stronger, faster. You couldn't name 2-3 running backs who were as versatile. He could run the football, obviously, with great vision. He gave you a piece. He never gave you a full kind of hit. He could throw the football. He was a tremendous blocker. His nose for the goal line, third and one, fourth and one, need the score. Marcus found a way. Here's the other thing that immediately pops into mind when I think of Marcus. Tough. Tough. All day tough. If you're going to get into it, kill him, because he's just going to keep coming back.
In 1982, he won Rookie of the Year. In 1983, he lifted the Raiders to a championship. In the playoffs, all the elements of his greatness were on display in one of the most dominant performances by a running back in postseason history. But it began with a little luck against the Steelers' legendary linebacker, Jack Lambert.
As I made a cut, dirt flew in his eye and he turned away. I'm running for a touchdown.
Allen finished with 121 rushing yards and two touchdowns as the Raiders ran away from the Steelers. The win set up a rematch with the Seahawks, a team that had beaten the Raiders twice that season.
Seattle knew us so well. Yeah, I mean, it's no secret. I mean, they even knew our plays. I looked across the line of scrimmage from Kenny Easley. I shook my head and I said, I'm coming right there. I think he shook his head back and said, okay. All I remember was coming out with a black eye and seeing stars, but I wasn't going out the game.
Allen went from seeing stars to being the brightest of them all. He finished with 154 yards rushing, 62 receiving, and scored the Raiders' final touchdown. But his greatest performance was still to come.
It was 12 seconds ago in the third quarter. Power play off the left side, 17 Bob Treo. Ken Coffey came up in a reverse field, and in doing so, he almost got the ball out. After I made that turn, everything slowed down. I remember Neil Okowitz just grasping. I mean, I could almost see the anxiety on their faces and the tension as I was running by. And then about 20 yards from the goal line, everything came back to normal speed.
Already had a call from Moscow. They think that Marcus Allen is a new secret weapon, and they insist that we dismantle it.
Allen was on top of the world and the king of Los Angeles, but it wouldn't last.
Microsoft Surface is part of the NFL, so are superstitions.